celebration of the 13th Triple Crown winner, undefeated Triple Crown Justify. But there's controversy. What would this world be without a little controversy? Things have exploded a little bit. Tom Padua did a nice story on New York Post, a fair story. But that story on the New York Post has exploded a little bit with comments from owners like Gary West and especially Mike Rapoli. We're talking about Restoring Hope, written by Florent Giroux, owned by the Wests, entered in the race as a likely horse who would be on or near the lead. But there's reason to think that his run, especially in the first few furlongs of the Belmont Stakes, was not completely above board kosher and maybe a little bit overt in his actions to act as some sort of interference for the other Baffert, the winner, Justify.
Yeah, there's certainly been a lot of hoo-ha about that topic, and Twitter and social media certainly do their share in fanning the flames of that fire. But in my opinion, Brian, I don't see it. I think for Mike Rapoli, the owner of Vino Rosso, I think it was a little bit of a Steve Coburn type reaction. And I'm referring to back when California Chrome lost and Steve Coburn lost his mind on national TV. Rapoli's comments were not on national TV, but I think it was a little bit of an emotional overreaction to what was going on. I've watched the replay a bunch of times, and you know, I guess I can see where it's coming from. But if anything happened, it clearly had no effect on the way the race played out, and clearly did nothing to aid Justify.
Matt, I am going to have to disagree with you a little bit there. I, like you, have seen replays, angles. In fact, our guy Mark Midland has a new story on Horse Racing Nation examining the issue, and I think that's a really good read if you get a chance to get to Horse Racing Nation for that article on transparency, at least. Yeah, there's a lot of things here. First off, what Restoring Hope did in the run into the first turn and then early into the turn, it looks bad to me. There was a little bit of bumping. Bravazo bumped Restoring Hope. Giroux, among the few comments that he made was that his horse was a little rank early, but the way he was rushed up and how wide he went in the first turn, which did directly affect Noble Indy's ability to make more of a lead, a run for the lead, it looked fishy. And then the way Giroux quickly not really went after Justify, but he went after the inside again. After going floating eight wide on the turn, he made a pretty sharp move to get back inside. It almost looked unnatural to me for him to want to yank his horse so quickly inside, which did block Bravazo a little bit, another potential horse who would go after Justify early. So given that, and given the fact that, you know, Windstar Farm, there was some questions about what exactly they're trying to do a few years ago, or not even questions. It was pretty overt that when they had Creator win the Belmont, Gettysburg was a speed horse. Gettysburg was with Pletcher. All of a sudden he was with Asmussen, and Gettysburg helped set the table because Creator basically won the Belmont in the last stride or two over Destin. And Destin was affected to some extent by Gettysburg. So Windstar has a little history in trying to be the puppet master here and pull the strings a little bit. So,
yeah. And, you know, I agree with you much more about the Creator Destin Belmont Stakes, because there was the taking the horse away and giving it to another trainer. And to me, that was a situation where everything was right out on the table, the motives and what was going to happen. What went on in the Belmont Stakes with Giroux's ride and such is all very, you know, is all kind of hazy and unfocused and hard to know, you know, everybody's telling a story and I mean, just what is what happened out there match what Giroux said? I guess it kind of does, but you know, in the end, like I said before, I don't think anything that happened had any effect on the result of the race. Justify was just flat out too good, as opposed to with Creator and Destin and Gettysburg, where it probably did determine the outcome of that race.
Fair enough, and I'm not going to disagree with you. I'm not going to sit here and say that Justify wouldn't have won the race anyway. But if there was something said before the race, Baffert, Windstar, Giroux, that does bother me a little bit that they're planning to run interference, for lack of a better way of saying it. I think betters and racing fans deserve more, and maybe not the fairest play in the world if that's in fact what happened. But I don't think we're going to get anywhere with this. The stewards aren't really pursuing the issue too much, going after Giroux and finding out about that. It was odd that Javi Castellano seemed to not listen to Rapoli or what Rapoli assumed Pletcher's instructions to Javi Castellano were, and it went so far, Matt, that Rapoli's quoted as saying, "I will not ride Castellano anytime soon." So obviously there was some bad feelings there, where one of the top jockeys and a jockey who rides a lot of Pletcher and Rapoli horses, but on the other hand, he was on a horse that was partially owned by Windstar Farm. So there's that conspiracy theory as well. What was Castellano doing not trying to go after the lead, and did in fact Restoring Hope hinder Castellano's any chance to go after Justify a little bit more early?
Yeah, and you know, and again, I am going to credit it, Rapoli's comments, with a little bit of disappointment with the result of the race and a lot of feeling and emotion going on in a race, the Belmont Stakes, that's very important to him. It's also been reported and observed that Noble Indy acted up a great deal in the paddock and in the post parade, seemed to be a little bit stirred up by the crowd and everything that was going on. So, you know, by the time they got to the starting gate, maybe Noble Indy didn't want to be too much a part of the racing by that point. Yeah, it's, hey, bottom line, I'm just going to say it again, is that none of this affected the outcome of the race. You know, my only other thing is that racing has gone completely away from coupled entries when there's joint ownership, to have more betting interests in races, to increase the handle. And I don't know, maybe that's not where we need to be any longer.
Yeah, this was a strange setup, an incestuous setup, if you will, yep. Matt, with the many, many owners of Justify and the joint ownership, partial joint ownership here and there. So it was almost asking for a little bit of conspiracy yes. theory. Hey, everybody loves conspiracy theory. Unfortunately, I think for racing, it doesn't look good. You know, we know a lot about racing. We've been around racing a long time. Most everybody that's watching our show right now knows a lot about racing, but there's a lot of people that don't hear about racing other than the Kentucky Derby and the Triple Crown. And now where you have this story coming out about maybe a little dirty dealing, maybe a little bit of helping the Triple Crown winner become a Triple Crown winner, it just doesn't look good for racing.
No, and all of this is probably happening now because of the sparks that initiated this fire a couple weeks before the race with the audible being removed from consideration. Another Windstar, and in my mind, that whole thing going on there is probably what you know, got this kind of discussion going so heatedly after the Triple Crown.
That's right. Windstar Farm has a lot of money in all of this, and creator Gettysburg a few years ago, Audible suddenly not training as well is the story that came in, but not running as one of the horses that Justify would really have to worry about in the Belmont. There's reason why we're talking about it today, but again, Matt, I'm with you. The best horse won, and he was going to win probably no matter what the tactics of Noble Indy or Bravazo were, and without any sort of interference by Restoring Hope. But an interesting story.